Yes, I can. What? I can't see myself, though. Oh. Hello.
Hi.
How are you, Filipina?
I'm good, darling. You look gorgeous.
You two look stunning, too. And, you know, I was just getting a bit emotional while you were talking about all of that stuff that I had to stop listening, you know.
Yeah.
I was tearing up.
Yeah.
And it's such wonderful memories. But the thing that I remembered was that I was only 9 years old when I started in show business.
No way!
Isn't that mad?
I was 9 years old like you guys were.
Yeah.
When you started. And then Uncle Lionel saw my enthusiasm, like I guess I saw in you guys. Mm. And he asked me, would I like to sing a solo number as a 9 year old? So I did, and I sang Sugar in the morning, sugar in the evening, sugar at supper time. And all those memories came flooding back to me when you were talking about your early days on Young Talent Time. And I guess, you know, the simpatico that I had with you guys had to do with that I'd experienced it myself.
Yeah.
You know, I was a 12-year-old going on to talent quests. And then by the time I was 14, I had my first rock and roll band, you know, singing Chuck Berry songs and all that sort of stuff. So, and then by the time I was 17, I had my first television show. And then by the time I was 19, I had my second television show. And that was all before Young Talent Time.
Wow.
And then on the 24th of April, 1971, after having 10 years of rocking and rolling and all of that, you know, involved, I was asked to do a program to go up against the football replays.
Wow.
And they tried all sorts of other programs, and they hadn't had any luck with it on a Saturday night. So they gave me a contract for 4 episodes of Young Talent Time for,
wow,
you know, next to no money. And I had always loved the Mickey Mouse Club.
Mm.
You know, when I was 9 years old, I wanted to be on the Mickey Mouse Club, and they had, you know, Jimmy the host, who was the big brother kind of figure. So the whole concept of Young Talent Time came from my love for the Mickey Mouse Club.
Oh.
And so, you know, it was wonderful. And so that was it. I did 4 episodes of Young Talent Time, and Nolene Watson was the producer. Johnny, out to the studio, please. And, you know, I got pushed around like you guys did. And it was fantastic, because after the first 4, the very first rating we had, they had had a 3 the week before, and they got a 19.
Oh, my goodness.
Sight unseen, Young Talent Time.
And isn't
Johnny and the Kids.
And isn't that interesting that you at that particular point in time also gave sport, you challenged sport. For the first time you challenged sport with a variety TV show, and you would have made the network rather scared at the time. Can you imagine?
Oh, it was. I mean, they gave me 4 episodes and that was it. And then at the end of the 4 episodes, we'd done so well that they gave me a 4-year contract.
Wow.
You know, and that's when you guys started to get involved with it. And can I ask you a question? Simply a question for me, because we've never had this discussion. But was I okay as a boss?
Yeah, for me. But what I find so funny about what you said before was that you love the football so much. It was a religion for you. So for you to make a TV show that's going up against the repeat of the football is hilarious, because
absolutely,
we always knew if you arrived after a game, we're like, oh, God, I hope his team wins, because we knew everyone was walking on eggshells. If your team didn't win, it was just like we knew your head was kind of clouded, and then as soon as the cameras would roll, boom, you were there giving everybody, like, just that same show. Like, you were so steady with every show. And I love the fact that you were so young when you started, but you're actually so experienced. I had no idea you started at 9 and you'd done all of these different things. And
that's extraordinary.
That pop music heritage that was running through you and all those hit songs. Anyone else would have just, you know, gone home and relaxed after that. I've had 5, you know, hit songs. I'm done. I'm rock and roll. I can go out and party. No, I mean, for you to take this on and then, yeah, when 4 episodes, you don't know that's going to turn into years and everybody's childhood growing up.
For me, the 18 years of Young Talent Time, I actually lived it. You know, it was wonderful, and I had lovely relationships with your parents. You know, Franca was, you know, she was tough. She was demanding and tough, and that's great. And of course, the beautiful Carol, you know, who was a Miss Victoria and was as stunningly beautiful as you are.
Still
Dannii.
Is.
She, you know, she was there. Every show, she was there. She was dedicated and supportive, as Franca was. You know, and I think that was an important ingredient in Young Talent Time, because we didn't spend a lot of time socially together.
It's interesting, and what's really important to point out as well is the role that family played in that show.
Oh, right? 1,000%.
Agendas and the beauty of that particular time. Our parents, of all the kids, they were there for an honourable reason. Their children were there, they were a part of a family, we're all part of a family. We all grew together. If we made mistakes, we made mistakes together. It was wonderful. It was a family, and that was something that was very much guided by yourself. Now, having understood your history as a 9-year-old, it makes complete sense why you had that beautiful trajectory and that incredible balance between craft and families. What we unfortunately have seen today, and we can see that with Britney Spears' story, which is one of many stories, and she's also a former Disney Club, Mickey Mouse Club member, is that her family and her education and trajectory was nothing to what it is that we experience. And that is what's ultimately very sad, living today and watching what has gone on with a woman who is a child performer but didn't come from a family of being protected. This girl was not protected. We were. We were by our own families, and we were protected by you. That's a gift. And nothing to ever be underplayed either. I'm very aware of that now in my 50s where I go, how fortunate I feel. I can't speak for the others, but I was fortunate.
You both got kids. You're both mothers. Would you let them go through a Young Talent Time type experience?
Absolutely. But, I mean, times have changed now. It was a magical time back then, and absolutely, for me, it was a joy to go to work. It wasn't a chore. The other kids became my family. Their parents became my family. But what I have to say is that not only with our parents being at rehearsal supporting us, but now being a mum, I realise how much they needed each other. I can't imagine what it would have been like. There's no media training or anything, and your child is so famous, there's no street that they're going to walk down without getting recognised. So I think our parents had to talk to each other and help each other through that process. And the biggest thank you has to go to the other parents that were at home looking after the other kids and the other siblings. The other siblings that really didn't have that time with that parent that was with us and that allowed us to do this is the most special bond ever. And I think they don't get the credit for that.
And you know, a lot of the crew and the production people, like Vicky, who's working on this this program as well, made a wonderful contribution. There's still so much enthusiasm and love from the crew, you know, for the program. And that's unique. And you know what? It wasn't planned. You know, I didn't say, hey, I'm going to do a program for 18 years and I'm going, nothing. It just all happened
Well, that's the beauty. You see, that's the beauty about spontaneity and learning to trust your instincts as a performer, which is something that is not really played out today. Today, everything is very formulaic. Everything is within a box. You can't think or can't do outside that. Whereas we got to play in a playground where we could think on our feet. Where we could do whatever it is. And that education you can never, ever underestimate. Can you, Dan?
Yeah. It was fun. And when you're having fun, everything is so easy.
Yeah.
Okay,
bye,
you've got
John.
To go.
Bye-bye.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Love you.
Thank you. Lots
Thank
of
you.
Love.
Love you, darling.
Bye.
Speak to you
bye.
Soon. Love to Mariska.
And love to Carol and love to Franka too, please.